Welcome to this session on how to test a mobile phone application in JMeter. In this session, we are going to go very basic. We will start from scratch and we will learn how can we test a web application on mobile and record the action inside JMeter. Towards the end of this session, we will also look at some useful tips. So let's get started. And the first step is we have to start JMeter on our laptop or desktop. So I have my JMeter running. You can also get your JMeter ready. And let us directly go to step number 2, which is we have to add a template recording which will record our actions inside JMeter. So basically we need to get a test script recorder. We can do that manually as well, and we have a separate session where I have shown how to use test script recorder, but we will go the easy way. JMeter provides us templates. So here is the icon for templates. You can also go to File and Templates, and we will select recording template and say create. So it will give us a template with all the necessary components we need in our recording. If you go to the thread group, you have this recording controller, and if you go to the workbench, we already have this HTTP test script recorder. So now we have a recording template ready. Let us go to step number 3, which is we have to set port for recording. So in your HTTP test script recorder, we have this option for port. So you can set any port here. The same port we will set in our mobile phone so that we can record the actions from there. So I am setting 8181 here. And the next step is we have to click start, and then we have to install the root CA certificate. So in case you are doing this for the first time, when you will go to your recorder and you will hit the start button here, you will get this option for installing root CA certificate. So what this means is, as soon as you will click start, a certificate will get generated in your JMeter's bin directory. So if you go to your JMeter, wherever you have installed your JMeter, go inside the folder, go inside the bin directory, and you will get this certificate created. And this certificate you have to install in your browser. So in case you are using a browser within your desktop or laptop, you can install it there. We already have seen this in our session on how to use test script recorder, but here we have to install this certificate on our mobile phone. So let us see how to do that. Here I am showing you the screen of my Android phone. So to install the certificate, we have to go to settings and then go to your Wi-Fi. And here you have this options. Go here, and here we have to go to advanced. So here you will get this option to install certificate. So you can transfer the certificate from your laptop or desktop to your mobile phone through a file transfer or any other means, and then you can install the certificate on your Android phone. Now the next step is we have to configure the IP and port on our mobile phone. So let us learn how do we do that. So first of all, note down the IP of your system. In case you are on Mac, you can go to network preferences pane, and there you should be getting your IP. For example, my IP is here. In case you are on Windows, you can go to your command prompt on Windows, and here you can type the command ipconfig, and this should show you your IP address. Let us now configure the IP and port on our mobile phone. Now I am on my Android phone, and you do not have to connect your phone physically through a cable to your computer, but you should be on the same Wi-Fi network. So here we have to go to settings, go to Wi-Fi. Here long press on the Wi-Fi that you are connected to, go to modify network, and here you will get this option to show advanced option. Click here, and then if you go down, you will get this proxy. Here we have to select manual, and then here in the proxy host name, we have to give the IP of the machine where our JMeter is running. So in my case, it will be 192.168.0.100. And then you have to give the same port that we have given in our JMeter. So I will say here 8181, and then we have to save it. Also make sure that the IPv4 settings are set to DHCP. So after you save this, our Android phone is now ready with the setup. And now we can start our recording. So let us see how to do that. So now we are ready with all our setup, and now we can start recording our actions on our Android phone. So let me also show you my Android phone screen. So here, now we will start recording, and you can see whatever we will record on our Android phone will get recorded into JMeter in the recording controller. So let me go to my Android phone and let me go to this website lifecharger.org, and you can see all the actions and all the samples are getting recorded here in JMeter. So I'm going to the home page, and then I'm going to this article, and then let me go to another page. Let me go to archives page, and I can now go back to my test script recorder, and I can stop the recording now. So I will stop the recording now. So here you can see under the recording controller, JMeter has captured all the actions that we have done on our Android phone, and all the samples are recorded. So now you can either create a separate thread group and filter out the samples that you need from the recorded samples and disable and delete the others. Here I will just create a listener. I will add a listener inside the same thread group. I will add view results tree, and I can now just run this to check our test, and you can see everything is passing. So of course you can give some meaningful names to these samples. So you can say this is home page, and similarly you can give some other names, and we are getting a successful result. So this is how we can use JMeter to record our Android applications. And then the last step, run and validate, that we have already done. Let us also look at some useful tips. So make sure that your mobile and your laptop or your desktop where your JMeter is should be connected to the same Wi-Fi network. And also, in case there is any other network connected on your phone, please make sure that you turn that off. I hope this session was very useful for you. In case you have any questions, please do write them down in the comments section, and I will try to reply as soon as I can. Thanks for watching, and keep learning.